Hi everyone. Myself Manoj KP, working as a lecturer in Government Polytechnic Kushalnagar in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. So in the sixth unit is a special motor. In this session, we are going to deal with session number 48. It's a universal motor. So this is a picture of a universal motor. Universal motor. See, in this picture we can see each and every parts of a universal motor, the stator and the rotor. Here the field winding is a stator winding. The armature is a rotor. The brush, the commutator, the shaft, everything is been clearly shown in this universal motor. So the universal motor. Universal motor is a special type of motor which is designed to operate on either DC or AC. It is basically a series wound motor. It has high starting torque and variable speed characteristics. So the universal motor is a special type. Why do they call it special type? Means we can operate it on both AC as well as DC supply. It need not need only the AC or the only the DC. It can operate both on AC as well as DC supply. Hence, it's a special one. This is also called a series wound motor. Why it's so called a series wound motor means the armature and the field winding both are connected in series. Hence, the name is also called a series wound motor. So, since the both windings are in series, obviously it will have high starting torque and variable speed characteristics. So starting torque will be very high. Hence, the starting torque is very high. We cannot start with no load. Hence, we have to connect in the load. And the speed also. We can achieve this different type of speed in this universal motor. So the next one is the construction of universal motor. See, this is a picture of a universal motor. It's a cross-section view. In the first picture, we can see that the magnet. The magnet nothing but the field windings. Then the rotor, the armature one, the shafter, which is the assembly which is going to rotate these things. So the second picture is also the same thing which will be disassembled from the motor part. The stator and the rotor has been separated. And the rotor part is being kept aside so that we can able to clearly see the armature winding, the commutator and the shaft. These are the things. This is construction. So it costs mainly the two parts, the construction part, the stator and the rotor. The first we're going to deal with the stator part. Here in the stator, in the picture we can clearly see the stator windings, the stator and the stator winding. So it consists of a stator on which the field poles are mounted. Field coil are wound on field poles. The whole magnetic circuit is laminated to reduce eddy current. So in this picture, no, we can see that the poles, what we call the pole, which produce magnetic flux. This we are not using permanent magnet, we are using electromagnet. So the coil is made mandatory here. Hence, the field winding is been placed on the pole. The pole will consist of two things, no? Here, to either side, it's the pole. On the pole, we are going to have the pole winding. And this each and every winding is been laminated so that the eddy current is completely reduced. We cannot completely eliminate it. We are reducing as much as possible because the eddy current, if it's get higher, no, then if we induce a voltage, it's going to reduce the flux. Hence, in order to reduce the eddy current, we are using the laminations for each winding. So the next is the rotor part. See here, it's the rotor. In the picture, we can clearly see the rotor. It's been separated from the motor and kept aside so that we can able to identify how the rotor is and what are the parts comes under the rotor. See, the rotor, this one is the shaft, then is the armature core. In the armature core, we're going to provide the armature slot. In this armature slot, we're going to provide the armature winding. Then the winding is being connected to the commutator. Why commutator? The commutator is mainly purpose of commutator is for the conversion either from AC to DC or from DC to AC. Whichever the supply we are going to input, no, for the conversion we are going to use the commutator. This is the rotor part. So, and the shaft, the complete assembly of these, the armature core, the armature slot, armature winding, as well as the commutator, the entire assembly is being mounted on the shaft, which we can clearly see here. So, coming to this one, the construction part, the armature is wound type, having a straight or screwed slots. The commutator with brushes rest on it. The commutation on AC is poor than that of AC. High resistance brushes are used. So, here the grooves have been made, no, it is straight grooves we are going to provide. So that it becomes a slot in the armature. When the slots come across, we can easily provide winding so that the winding will be tight and tidy. It can carry the current and torque can be produced as much as possible as we require and we desired for. So the commutator with the brush rests on it. So this on the shaft, the commutator is going to rest, is being mounted. On this commutator, we're going to provide brush. The main purpose of the brush which we are using here is a high resistance brush. The brush, its main purpose is to collect the current or to input the current. Since it's a motor, here we are inputting the current to the rotating part. So we have to go by stationary only, no? Otherwise everything will become Z. That's why the brushes is being used, so that through brush we can inject the current to the armature, which is the rotating one. For that purpose, the brush is being used. Here the high resistance brush we are going to use. And the commutation on AC is poorer than DC. In DC, the commutation process, you know, that takes place, the shifting of the brush and sparking takes place, no? It's higher in DC when compared to an AC. So this was the rotor. Next. Okay. Here, see here, both the stator and the rotor is being given one single picture. So the stator parts, what are the stator parts over here? Obviously the yoke, it's the stator part. Then comes the field. The field, the name of the poles. The poles and the pole winding, which we call as field winding. And the brush, these are the stator things. And the remaining parts is so called as rotor, which are the rotor parts. The coming with the first, the shaft, the armature core, the armature slot, the armature conductor, and as well as the commutator. These are the rotor part. In this picture, you can see now. Yeah. Yes. Next one. The working. Yeah, here. See, we can see clearly see the circuit diagram of an universal motor. How it look like. See here, the coming with the supply, we can apply AC as well as DC source. Both. So the first, we come up with the green color, no? The green color indicates from there the winding will be starting. This is starting winding. It keeps go to the pole, nothing but the north pole. It's nothing but the magnet, electromagnet. From there the continuously is going to the brush to the armature. The one end. Then the another end of the brush is coming out from the armature to the brush, from then brush to again going to the south pole. From back to south pole to supply. So the entire thing, the winding, the field winding and the armature winding, both are connected in series. That's why it's so called as the series wound motor. The construction part, as we studied earlier. See, in circuit diagram, we can clearly say that it's a series motor. Series motor. So it's coming to the working principle. A universal motor works on either DC or single phase AC. So it can work on DC as well as single phase. We are not using for three phase. It can work on single phase only. Okay. When the universal motor is fed with DC supply, it works as DC series motor. See how it says? Why in series motor? When supply is given as DC, it works as a series motor. So, the series motor means the armature winding as well as free winding, they both has to be in series. So, in single one loop, and so called a series motor. When the current flow in the field winding, it produces electromagnet. Oh yes, see here. When the current is going to flow in the field winding, obviously, it is going to produce electromagnetic field. The field which is required to produce flux. As the current is flowed through them, we're going to get electromagnetic field. When the same current also flows from armature connector, so the current is flowing to the pole windings, then the same current will be flowing through the armature connector. When current carrying connector is placed in electromagnetic field, it experiences a mechanical force. Due to this mechanical force, the rotor starts rotate. The direction of this force is given by Fleming's left hand rule. See here, the field winding as well as the armature winding, both are connected in series. So the same current flows from the field winding as well as to the armature winding. So when current has been supplied, the current will pass through the magnet and the electromagnet will be injecting and the same current will be flowing to the armature. So what will happen? Then the mechanical force will be induced in the rotor part, so it will going to start rotate. This is the mechanism, and the direction of the force is given by Fleming's left hand rule. See, this is the Fleming's left hand rule. The thumb indicates the direction of rotation, the middle finger represents the direction of flux, and the middle finger represents the direction of induced current or the current or the voltage. Here the current, since it's a motor, it's the direction of the current in which it's going. The forefinger indicates it's a flux. The thumb finger indicates it's a direction of rotation. The three fingers has to be perpendicular, see 90 degree and here 90 degree and these two also 90 degree. This is what it indicates. So direction of current is being given by Fleming's left hand rule. The next, it's all about DC. Now we are coming with the AC supply. If you fed with AC supply, it still produces unidirectional torque. The armature winding and the field windings are connected in series. They are in same phase. The polarity of the AC changes periodically. The direction of current in the armature and the field winding reverses at the same time. So earlier it was in DC supply. So the DC supply is given that both the field winding and the armature winding will get excited, or the current going to flow in the same current will be flowing. The function of the pole is to produce flux. Since the flux and the armature current goes, it will be torque produced. This is what in the DC supply. But in AC, since the direction will keep on changing, positive, negative. Hence, since both the armature winding and the field winding both are connected in series, hence the timing of change, you know, from north to south, the direction, it will be happening simultaneously in the field winding as well as in the armature winding. Hence, the direction of the current in the armature and the field winding reverses at the same time. So it remains same. Hence, see here, the direction of the force experienced with the armature connector remains same. The resultant, no? Since the both are changes simultaneously in the field as well as in the armature, it results the armature connector direction remains same. Regardless of AC or DC supply, universal motor works on the same principle as that of DC series motor. So it's mainly the series motor, the working principle is same as that of series motor, whether it's going by AC supply or DC supply. So next, the application one, it got vast number of applications. See, the first one is the vacuum cleaner. We are the universal motor. No, we can come across these things in our day-to-day life. These are the best example which we're going to see in our day-to-day life. The first one is the vacuum cleaner. This portable vacuum cleaner, no? Here we are going to use D. It's a special motor, which is an universal motor, which can operate both on AC as well as DC. Next, coming for the food mixer. You have already seen in the kitchens, the food mixers will be there. While doing the cooking, the food, we have to get help of this food mixer, which works on where the universal motor has been kept. So, in the food mixer, there will be a universal motor. The next one is a domestic sewing machine. Oh, the sewing machine also, it consists of a universal motor. So, it's a series motor. We need to pedal. While sewing, no, we need to pedal. It gives a lot of strain and the work will be reduced. Hence, if you use a motor, it's nothing but a universal motor. The sewing machine uses a universal motor. And the portable drills, the drill which we carry to make a grooves on the walls, on the wooden tables, etc., etc. These are things which uses universal motor. The next is the blender. So when you have to blend for food blending, we use universal motor for blending purpose. So next one. This is a picture of the various application. So the what I say the blending, no? This is the blending or food mixing, the mixer. Most of them it used for the blending. When you keep on mixing properly, no? It's the same proportion, then the food get blended by itself. And it gives a lot of taste. In this blending machine, we use universal motor. This application, how see here, the kitchens. In the kitchens, obviously we will be seeing the mixers. The mixers for doing chutneys and the curries, as well as juice. The mixers, the varieties of mixers we will be having. This food mixers. So this is an example of an universal motor. So we can come across in our day-to-day life, but we will be not aware what kind of motor we will be using there. So it's nothing but it's an universal motor. See, vacuum cleaner. In the vacuum cleaner also, we are going to use a universal motor. It has to suck no things. So hence, it requires a lot of pressure. Hence, we are going to use its universal motor in vacuum cleaner. Sewing machine. See, as I told you, no, sewing machine. It's also considered of universal motor. It will be placed here. It can run both on AC as well as on DC. These are the things. How the drilling machine? See the drilling machine. It's a portable drilling machine which we use for drilling or growing the walls, tables, etc. This one. So next, we are going to have the MCQ question. So as of now, we have studied about the universal motor. What's the universal motor? It runs both on AC as well as DC. It's a series wound motor. Why the name is so called a series wound motor? Means the armature and the field winding both are connected in a same path. Hence, it's so called as a series wound motor. Here, the handling machine, which are using in a lot of applications, will be using for universal motor. We'll be not aware of that one. In this session, the most of thing, everyone will be aware what kind of motor is used. Here. Okay. Next, we go to the MCQ question. The first one. In universal motor, the poles are mounted on dash. See the poles. What is the use of poles? The purpose of poles is used to serve to give the magnetic flux. It's the stator. Let's see, the first option is stator, the second option is rotor. The third one, both stator and rotor. Fifth one, none of the above. So, obviously, the universal motor, the poles are mounted on stator part. It's a stationary one. The next question. The whole magnetic circuit is laminated in pole to reduce dash, to reduce voltage, to reduce current, or eddy current, or insulation resistance. So, in the whole magnetic part is being laminated in order to reduce eddy current. What? Eddy current we have to reduce or minimize. For this purpose, we are using laminations in pole. Next, the universal motor works on dash supply. Okay, in which supply could be only AC or only DC, or both AC as well as DC, or maybe sometimes AC or sometimes DC. So the answer is both AC as well as DC. The next, in universal motor, the field winding and armature winding are connected in dash. Universal motor. So in the picture now, so from supply it's going to the field winding, from another end of the field winding is going to the brush, from another end of the armature brush is coming out, again it's going to the field winding and coming back to the supply. Hence it's a series, they are connected in series. The next one, the torque produced in universal motor is dash. A. Unidirectional, bidirectional, multidirectional, or polydirectional. The answer is unidirectional. So, irrespective of the supply, whether it's an AC or DC, the direction of rotation will be always unidirectional in universal motor. Universal motor works on same working principle as that of dash. So earlier problem was, you know, one of the sir came and told what kind of subject we are dealing with. So here the universal motor works on same working principle as that of DC series motor, option 4. So DC compound motor, shunt motor, induction motor, but the answer is DC series motor. Which of the following application make use of universal motor? Portable tools, yeah, we know the portable tools. The drilling machine is the best example of the portable tools. Then nowadays the sewing machine also, you know, it also came in the compact size so that we can able to carry wherever we need it. The next is the lathe machine. So the lathe machine. Next is the pump, water pumps. Last one is all of the above. So, which of the following application make use of universal portable tools? So, we could use lathe machines for water pump it or so. Hence, the answer is portable tool. The speed of universal motor is dash, dependent on frequency supply, proportional to frequency of supply, independent to frequency of supply. The last option is none of the above. So, the speed of the universal motor is dependent on the frequency of supply. The main thing is it depends upon frequency of the supply. So in what 60, the majority of an Indian system which we use the frequency is 50. But in European countries they will maintain 60, the frequency of supply. 60. The next one, which motor is relatively free from mechanical and magnetic vibration? Mechanical as well as magnetic vibration. The shaded pole motor, universal motor, relaxation motor, hysteresis motor. So the answer is universal motor, where the mechanical and magnetic vibrations are present only in universal motor. Relatively free, we cannot say present, they are free from universal motor. Now the last but not the least, generally used motor in food mixer is dash, capacitor start motor, shaded pole motor, reluctance motor, and universal motor. Obviously the answer is universal motor. So this was the session under which we are going to have a brief introduction and working as well as the construction part of the universal motor. So the entire universal motor which we are going to use now, here the universal motor. The universal, why the name is so called universe means it can run both as well as AC as well as DC circuit. Hence its name is called as universal. Again, the winding, it just resembles the winding of a DC series motor. But the power capacity is, it has to be less than 1 kilowatt. Then only we can come across it into universal motor. So the stator part is the pole winding and the brush. The rotor part is the armature core, armature slot, armature winding, commutator and the shaft. These are the things. So by now we are able to discuss regarding the universal motor. These are the references books which I use. The first one is B.L. Tereja and E.K. Tereja, Electrical Technology, Volume 2. Next one, The Principle of Electrical Machines by V.K. Mehta. And some other pictures and all, know regarding information I got in Google, YouTube, and this is the V website where it will be helpful for us to get data easily. So for the videos, these are the videos. And these are the team members for by which we are able to perform this very good activity. So this ends our session. So thank you everyone.